Hi friends, welcome to the new series JavaScript Hero to Superhero. In this series, I'm talking about some advanced concepts in JavaScript. If you are a beginner trying to learn JavaScript, there is another series, JavaScript 0 to Hero, in which I have explained all the basic concepts. In this video, I'm going to talk about this in JavaScript. This concept is one of the important but confused concepts. What is this in JavaScript? In JavaScript, the this keyword refers to an object depending on how it is used. Let me console log this in a browser. We can see it is giving us window object. Now let me execute the same code in VS Code. Now we can see it is giving us an empty object. And coming back to browser, let me create a function, and inside this function, let me console log this. And let me call this function. Now also we can see it is giving us window object. Now let me create an object here. And inside that, let me have an ID and a function. Inside this function, let me console log this and call this function. Here we can see it is giving this object instead of window object. So the rule of thumb is, if we execute inside a function which is a method in an object, this is going to refer that object. But if you are executing in a normal function or outside of all functions, it is going to refer the global object, which is window in browser and global object in node. That is why we can see it gives us window when we execute in browser and we got an empty object in VS Code. Hope you are clear in this now. Okay, let me clear this console. Now let me create a variable first name equal to Harry. Actually, this variable is created in the window object. So we can access this variable directly like this or using this keyword or using window.variableName. Similarly, we can use the this keyword to create a variable in window object and access it directly or like window.variableName. Also, we can use window.variableName to create a variable in window object and access it directly like this or using the this keyword. Okay, now let me create an object in which let me have an ID, a full name, and a function to greet the user. So here I can access this full name inside this greet function using the this keyword, because this is going to refer this person object here. So if I call this function, we can see this. Now let me create a color variable and assigning the value blue. And let me create a function myColor. Inside that, let me create another variable where color equal to red. Now let me console log apples are this.color. And let me call this function. We can see apples are blue. This is because, like I told before, when we access the this inside the function, it will refer to the window object. And in window object, we can see we have blue in the color variable. That is why apples are blue. Let me show you one more thing. Let me create an object called student, in which let me have a first name, a last name, and a function called details. Inside this details function, let me create another function called fullname. There, let me use a console log like this. And then let me call the fullname function inside. And here, let me call student.details function. Now we can see it is giving us undefined. This is because, like we discussed before, this particular function is a normal function. And so here this is going to refer the window object. But in window object, we don't have first name and last name. Only we have it in the student object. That is why it is giving us undefined. So how can we fix this? If we change this to the actual object, it will work. But as we are discussing about this concept, let me show you another method. Let me put some console logs. Now if I execute, we can see in this console log, this is referring to the student object because it is a method in the object. But in this console log, it is referring to the window object. So here we can create a new variable that equal to this. And instead of this here, we can use that. Now this that is referring to the student object. And so if I execute, we can see it is working. Let me also show you one last thing. For that, let me revert to the previous code. If I execute, we are getting undefined. Okay. Now let me change this function to an arrow function. Now if I execute, we can see it is working because the arrow function doesn't define its own execution context, no matter how or where being executed. This value inside of an arrow function always equals this value from the outer function. That is why we are seeing here, this is referring to the student object. Hope you understood and you like this video. Please subscribe and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.